first flyers.
Bless you, brother.
That's all our websites and our...
Okay, we're talking, in essence, control box computer on the left.
Yep.
This is just one...
One battery that controls your lights and your heater.
And then...
And the rest is batteries and converter. The brain, that is the brains.
Yeah.
But it's a simple car.
And then, wait a minute, you got...
Oh, I'm sorry.
220?
220, 110, yeah. And this is a 440. The 110 does 15 hours on 110. The 220 does about 4 to 6 hours, depending on how much you have in there. The 440 does 20 minutes to 30 minutes on, again, depends on how much you got in there. But that's the
To recharge.
To recharge. And the 440 goes up to 90%, but that's okay.
Whatever works.
Right.
Yes.
Whatever works.
And we're talking, this has the LiFePo battery. What are we talking?
This one, yeah, LiFePo, and it's got 8-year warranty on it.
On the battery?
On the battery.
How many miles?
Got all electric cars.
I don't know. Whatever, 8 miles of... Oh, 100,000. Thank you. 100,000 to 100,000 or 8 years. Yes.
There you go. That'll work. Now, this is what we call the old school,
this is our, hobbyist.
I've seen these 10 years ago,
Yeah.
You know, this is the batteries, the golf cart batteries. I don't know what if they're a golf cart or not, but.
This car had golf cart batteries in it until those.
Yep. So what are these?
Those are just AGM
batteries.
What's AGM stuff?
Absorb blast mat.
It's still lead acid.
But it's a new
version. Sealed lead acid battery.
Sealed lead acid.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Yes.
Doesn't have all the slots.
Thank you. Yeah, so more of a gel effect or something.
It's a gel.
It's not gel. It's still a liquid.
But
it's similar to the gel where it's not a
and then across that one part up there.
A viscous solution.
Bending and all that.
Yeah. The glass mat is actually absorbed the lead acid into its material. So it's actually you can puncture the battery. Nothing leak out. But it will evaporate out.
Yeah. Is this a kit you can get if I've already got one of these?
If you've already got one of those, you can order all those parts in a kit form if you want to, yeah.
Now, I may want somebody to help me put it together because... Wait a minute. They got a co-op. People help you put it together. Look at this.
That's our club. That's it.
Yeah,
North
yes.
Texas.
Are they here?
Because if I've got... it don't matter how many miles are on the engine because the engine...
Nope.
How many batteries in this unit?
This one's got 44.
So you got batteries in the trunk, batteries under the back seat.
The back seat. Yeah, it's beautiful, man.
And no batteries in the middle here.
No batteries anywhere else.
No batteries
all back there.
Okay, this is... yes, thank you. You got transfers. Okay, did you save the same transmission from the
original? Yes, stock transmission
with
a custom adapter plate for the motor to the transmission.
Excellent.
And this is still using the same clutch and everything as the original transmission. This is the motor controller. It got wires connected down to the motor. The pulse width modulation turns on the motor.
10-4.
Slower and faster to adjust speed up and down. And this is the charger right here.
Yes.
Your basic fuses to make sure that you don't be short the batteries. That fuse will blow before anything happens. You got your contact relays for your ignitions. You got your inertia switch. So if you had any impact, it'll automatically cut off the car and shut it off.
Thank you, yes.
The vacuum reservoir and the vacuum pump for the power brakes, so you can use the existing power brakes of the car. The air conditioning lines right underneath here, it's kind of hard to see, but it still has air conditioning. This is the condenser and the coil unit and the pumps underneath. These are the radiator lines for the controller because it gets warm from...
But you're using the same reservoir.
Well, this is aftermarket.
It's aftermarket. Actually, the Volkswagen reservoir actually sat right here, and I didn't realize until I was looking the other day I could have used there. It's a little ball reservoir I could have put right there.
Now, what's this?
That's the throttle cable.
That's the throttle.
Excuse me. Thank you.
Essentially, it's like a little pot switch.
Yes.
Yep. So I just connected to the cable.
Excellent.
And this one's nice because with this controller, I can actually plug my laptop into the controller, and I can set the parameters of the controller to the way I want the car to drive. And I can. And one of the problems with a lot of the cars with throttle, you only have a one motion throttle. You can't really adjust it. Well, with this, I can actually adjust how far my pedal goes, and it'll adjust it'll adjust it. So my pedal only moves this arm 50%, it'll adjust it to 100% of my throttle.
It's almost like a sports economy switch, I'm thinking, in a sense.
Well, no, what it does is my cable only pulls to right there.
Yeah.
So since it doesn't pull 100%, it readjusts it so that now that only 40% pull is now 100%, so it acts like a real throttle.
Oh, 10-4. It's adjusting electronically for the physical.
Exactly.
10-4, I understand.
Yeah. And then, of course, I can interface with the controller, and I can set the amount of amps I want it to pull. I can set the maximum voltage it'll take for my battery pack to protect the battery pack. I can set the minimum voltage it'll take, again, to protect the battery
pack. Get on the train, it's already 2:44.
Thank you, bud. Appreciate you guys.
No problem.